He's used this line so many times before when someone is about to essay a 10-foot putt for a 3 or a 4 or a 7. And now, the man we've all been waiting for.
Yeah, my media friends there, they also know I have this line about, I've got a lot to say, but they don't always get to say it all, you know? And it won't be tonight. You're going to get my plan B. My plan A went a little on the long side after I timed it out, so I'll spare you that. But I won't spare you a couple thoughts about my feelings about Emo and about Carol. I am really honored to be inducted into the Illinois Hall of Fame, period, but especially with those two. A little unknown fact, little known fact. My first golf lesson at age 11 came from Emil's brother, Lou. So I guess we could say that he made me the player I am today. And I remember, I can't quite remember the event, but it was not long after that. I caddied a lot when I was a kid, and I remember caddying in the same tournament that Carol Mann played in, and she won it. I wasn't her caddy, unfortunately, but anyway, I kind of go back a ways with her, and I talked to her before the selection of this year's Illinois Golf Hall of Fame, but just months before she passed on. And she, even though she was in the World Golf Hall of Fame already, she voiced interest that she really wanted to be in this one as well. So I'm glad that tonight she made that dream come true. This is really a big deal for me, and we've got a great family turnout for this. I'm really, really happy about it. My sister Julie and brother-in-law Joe are here from Wisconsin. My daughter Heidi and grandson Sterling are here all the way from North Carolina. And on Joy's side, she has two daughters-in-law and one son, and that's the special one here. Molly and Brian Sarver are here even though it's their 22nd wedding anniversary. So I thought that was pretty nice. Now, I've really been a lucky guy. You could call this lack of ambition, I think. I never wanted to really do anything work-wise other than what I did, and that dates all the way back to junior high. I wanted to write for a newspaper, maybe a little magazine work, stuff like that, and that's pretty much all I did, all I've done, and it's been a real whole lot of fun. I wouldn't trade it for anything, and we're kind of going on from there with it. Golf-wise, I came into the golf beat when I worked for the Sun-Times, and I was one of the very youngest, I was the youngest guy in the department at the time when the sports editor, Jim Mullen, declared me the golf writer, golf columnist. And the beat wasn't much then. We just went to the local tournaments and did a few features, and I was happy with that. But it was a time when the golf beat was exploding, and it wasn't long before I was... I covered other sports there too, but the golf beat was meant my summers would be going to a lot of the major championships. I mean, it was a very exciting time, very exciting time. I had my first U.S. Open happened to be the day that Johnny Miller, nobody heard of him back then, but he shot 63 in the final round at Oakmont on a rainy day. That wrote pretty well. And 1986 was my first Masters. A fella named Nicklaus won that one, and that was also his last record win in that tournament. And the back nine there was as good a sports drama as you'll ever find. It was really good. But the after 41 years, I was ready to retire. Joy and I were ready to hit the road and do some serious traveling. I wanted to tinker around with golf websites a little bit. And then a guy named Doug Ray came along. He's the publisher of the Daily Herald, and for some reason, he didn't think I was quite ready to go out to pasture yet. So, and I'm really glad he felt that way, because these last 10 years now, writing for the Daily Herald, a paper that has really been committed to golf coverage, it's really been a lot of fun and an honor to to keep going with that. And the travel hasn't hurt too much either. Joy and I have basically driving every time, and we got to think about that. 10 years, basically driving trips. We've hit 47 of the 50 states, and most all of them for golf stops, and that's been pretty good. And the website world, the wonderful world of websites, was brand new pretty much when I was just leaving the Sun-Times, but my daughter Heidi, she put together the initial version of Len Zeman Golf, and we kind of kicked it around, and now we've got 8 partners around the country, and we're not done yet. We're having a lot of fun with it. The thing about my stuff here is what I wanted to bring up tonight was the Illinois Golf Hall of Fame doesn't have many members from the media world yet. And I wanted to, I felt like I wanted to single out a group here who, most of them are all here, that I couldn't be here without them. It was, they all have different roles, but they're media related in the golf world. And I want to single them out. From the Hall of Fame selection process, it's Rory Spears, Tim Cronin, Ed Sherman. You saw him up there singing my praises. I don't know where that came from. We used to be bitter. We used to be bitter rivals. I mean, of course, Nick, the photographer. Nick and I did a book together once. A pretty fun experience too. Not all the time, but that was pretty much. From the Western Golf Association, I think that Gary Holloway and I were pretty much involved in these projects since day one. I think that he is my closest in time of service, and he's still going strong too. From the Sun-Times, my days there, Barry Cronin was my first and best golf writing partner. When things got real busy for the golf beat, I had to have somebody there with me, and Barry stepped right in. Of course, now you would know him better because he's been for over 20 years the media relations director at the John Deere Classic, and that's still an annual stop for us. I don't know if I'd ever stop seeing the John Deere Classic. One of my favorite events. And for the Daily Herald, of course, Doug, but also the sports editors there while I've been there, Tom Quinlan and now Mike Smith. They've been just great to work with and really supportive of golf and the crazy ideas I bring their way. From the Chicagoland Golf, Val Russell. From the Illinois PGA, both Palmer, of course, and his predecessor, Bill Ibrahim. We've had a lot of fun over the years doing the local scenes with those guys and also their colleagues, but especially those two. From the CDGA, Rich Skyzinski, Matt Baylor, and Casey Richards. From the Women's Western Golf Association, Susie Wagner. And then from the wonderful world of websites, which we've Joy and I've gotten into, and really have had a lot of fun with them. 4 of our 8 partner sites are from within the Chicago area. Of course, Tim and Rory both have theirs, and Cheryl Justack has Golf Now Chicago, and Dave Lockhart, our only member of the broadcast world, has Lynx Video. All those are all fun things. So anyway, I tell you, oh, and there's 2 others who have passed on, but I don't want them to certainly be forgotten. Reed Hanley was a longtime golf writer for the Chicago Tribune and a very good friend throughout the years until his passing. And same thing with Phil Kozin, who created both Chicagoland Golf and also the Illinois Women's Open. He did an awful lot in a short lifetime. So anyway, we still miss those guys. I've given you plan B in this speech. I didn't want to, my timing, I wanted to time this one out, and it was kind of setting time records, I think. I would have outlasted all these guys. I would have, but anyway, plan A is not to be lost. Plan A is not to be lost. If you're interested in some of the other goofy things that I've done, why I'm still doing this, number one, and more memories of some of the things that I've done. It's and a cheap attempt to boost sales to Len Zeman Golf. It'll be up on there tomorrow morning. And some of you also, you might just, if you do tune in, if you wait till later in the day, you might just see your picture on there as well. So anyway, it's I've been a lucky guy to be able to do all the things I've done. Golf has been, you know, it's I'm not a good player. My handicap's never been below 16. But I do have a hole-in-one, and I do have a few eagles, the last of which was made in Emil's company right here at the Glen. So we do go back a long way, a lot of things. Anyway, it's not over yet. I want to thank everyone for coming tonight. This was a real highlight for all of us, and as I say, look forward to seeing you all again.